be due to the breakdown of the bigger molecule into smaller ions. Carbon content, organic carbon content was decreased. Initially it was somewhere 40 to 50%, it was reduced to 27 to 30% or something like that. This reduction in carbon content is due to the loss of carbon as carbon dioxide, etc. Nitrogen content was increased during the vermicomposting. Initial nitrogen content was about 0.6% and it was increased to 2.3 or 1.8%, means there was 3 to 4 fold increase in the nitrogen content. Similarly, phosphorus was increased. So here also I would like to mention one thing, that okay, carbon dioxide may be lost by the process, by the earthworms. Nitrogen may be added by the earthworms, mucus production, etc., but phosphorus cannot be added from anywhere in the waste. Then how it is increasing? Basically, this phosphorus is increasing due to the reduction in the waste volume. When we do vermicomposting or composting, I think volume is reduced to 50% or 40% of the original waste. So that's why this phosphorus content is increasing. Similarly, we made study on the potassium content and these other metal contents, iron, zinc, copper, everything was higher in the vermicompost than the initial, and the reasoning is the same, that the volume is decreasing. CN ratio is another very important parameter, which is considered as a index of the stabilization of any waste. The upper line in the blue color is showing the CN ratio of the initial feed mixture which were given to the earthworms. So you will find that was somewhere near 40 to 60, but in the vermicompost it was somewhere near 15. So this clearly shows that the waste was stabilized or was converted into inorganics after vermicomposting. Yes, then if you come to the growth of the earthworms in different vermibins, you will find that the earthworms biomass increased in all the vermibins. Initially the growth was higher, then there was a stabilization, and then there is a decrease. This shows that this decrease indicate that there is no more food available for the earthworms, as all the waste has been converted into inorganics. Leave this. This is a total plan for this process, that you take waste, do its physicochemical characterization, check whether it is having some toxic content or not. If it is containing something toxic and salt content is higher, it cannot be used for the purpose of vermicomposting. Then, just 1 minute. Okay, then you add some organic waste to it, do its pre-composting. Pre-composting is very, very essential. Earthworms are not going to accept the waste, fresh waste. Earthworms will die immediately if earthworms are added in the fresh waste. Then after 3 to 4 waste, add earthworms, maintain optimum conditions of temperature and pressure, and then allow this bin or to this vermi bed to stay for say 13 to 15 weeks you have to, and then your waste will be converted into good quality vermicompost. You will be getting vermicompost as well as earthworms. Earthworms you can sell, you can get a good price for of the earthworms. The rate of the earthworms is about 300 to 500 rupees per kg. This is not working. Okay, this is a sample of the vermicompost which we have obtained from these experiments. In addition to this, I would like to show some of the photographs which I have. Without detailed discussion. Sometimes people do vermicomposting like this in open. We don't recommend this because earthworms are a very good feed for the birds and the rats. If you will be doing the vermicomposting in open like this, in the evening everything is okay, in the morning you will come and you will find there is not even a single earthworm, taken away by the rats and other predators. Yes, these are some of the beds which we are maintaining in the field with the help of earthworms. Here we have not used the food industry sludge, here we have used the cow dung. Yes, this is a small vermi bed which we have made in our laboratory. Yes, this is a 4-chambered vermi bin system. This is recommended for the houses in the urban areas. What is recommended in this, that you take waste and put in one chamber and allow it to get semi-composted for 30 days or so, and then put your earthworms in it. In the meantime, you start putting your waste in the second chamber. So what will happen, earthworms will feed on this first chamber. The Yersinia foetida species of the earthworm is free living species, means it can move in search of feed from one place to the other place. So once the waste is converted into vermicompost in the first chamber, worms will shift to the second chamber through the holes. Similarly, they will come to the third chamber and fourth chamber. So we say this is a cycle of 120 days, 4 month cycle. This is a bigger one, picture of the same thing. Yes, this is the another experiment which we did. Shade is required. So for the vermi beds, for the shade, what we did, we planted Jatropha plants. So here we got three products. One we got earthworms, second we got vermicompost, and third we got Jatropha seeds. This is another 85 cubic meter biogas plant. What we are doing, another that we are getting again three products. We are taking the waste, waste is taken to the biogas plant, and then slurry is taken for the vermicomposting. So we are getting again three products. One is biogas, second one is vermicompost, and third one is earthworms. This is just a pit for the pre-composting. Again, picture of some vermi beds. Yes, this is a bit important. There is a one more enemy, that is the red ants of the earthworms. So what we have suggested in these bins, that make a channel that is containing the water around your vermi beds. So these red ants cannot cross your this water channel and cannot affect your earthworms. Yes. As it is containing 60 to 80% moisture, some liquid will be coming out of your vermi beds. And the liquid which is coming out of the vermi beds, that is called as vermi wash. That vermi wash contains a number of nutrients, and this is a very good liquid fertilizer for horticultural crops. Can be collected like this in the pits. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Garg. So Goel, yes, he'll speak on city development, integrated and self-financed municipal solid waste management model for India. Great, please go ahead.
Good afternoon, friends. I'll be talking on city development, integrated and self-financed municipal solid waste management model for India.